Today we have an interesting mathematical challenge in which you have to calculate all numbers from 0 to 30 using only 4 number 4s. But before you do this, I would like to mention some rules that you need to follow. The first rule is that all number 4s must be positioned in line. The second rule states that combining two or more numbers is not allowed. So basically you cannot combine two 4s to get 44 or 4.4 or anything else. The third rule states that you cannot use any type of brackets. Sorry guys, but you have to manage without those in this challenge. Next, inserting any new numbers or adding more numbers is not allowed. That means that basically you cannot write 4 to the power of 0 to get number 1 or 4 squared to get 16. And the final rule, not equal sign, is not allowed because, let's face it, this is basically cheating. Alright, so keeping those rules in mind, you can now pause the video if you want to and try to solve this interesting challenge for yourself and then come back and check my solutions. Alright, so let's solve this challenge. First, let me just mention that there are numerous ways to solve those problems. And of course, since I do not want this video to be 3 hours long, I will just solve it in one way and you guys can do any other combination which you find, and of course, leave it down in the comment section below. Alright, so before I start solving this problem, I would just like to do a quick reminder about factorial and double factorial, because I'm going to use those in my solution. So, factorial is basically a product of all positive integers less than or equal to a given positive integer. For example, 6 factorial will be equal to the product of numbers 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1, which will give us 720. And in our case, I will use 4 factorial, which is of course 4 times 3 times 2 times 1, which is equal to 24. Next, let's check out double factorial. The double factorial of any number is product of all the positive integers up to that number that have the same parity, odd or even, as that number. So basically, if we have double factorial of 6, that would be equal 6 times 4 times 2, since 6 is an even number. And more interesting for us is 4 double factorial, which I'm going to use in my solutions, and this would be equal to 4 times 2, and that is 8. Alright, so with this in mind, let's go and check the solutions. First, we're going to check all single digit numbers from 0 to 9. And we're going to start with 0. So, for this one, it's pretty easy. It's 4 minus 4 plus 4 minus 4, which is, of course, 0 plus 0, and that is equal to 0. Next, let's check number 1. For this one, we can do something like 4 minus 4 plus 4 divided with 4. As you can see, that is 0 plus 1, which is equal to 1. Next, let's go to the number 2. I solved this one like 4 divided by 4 plus 4 divided by 4, which is of course 1 plus 1, and that is equal to 2. Next, number 3. Let's do this one. For this, I used square root, so square root of 4 plus square root of 4 minus 4 divided with 4, and that is 2 plus 2 minus 1, which is equal to 3. Alright, so let's get to number 4 next. For this one, I used combination of square root of 4 plus square root of 4 plus 4 minus 4. That is, of course, 2 plus 2 and 4 and minus 4 cancel each other out, so that is equal to 4. Now let's get to the right side, and let's do number 5. We can do this by square root of 4 plus 4 minus 4 divided with 4. That is 2 plus 4 minus 1, and that is, of course, equal to 5. Next is number 6. I did number 6 as a combination of square root of 4 plus 4 plus 4 minus 4. 4 and minus 4 cancel each other out, so we are left with 2 plus 4, which is equal to 6. Next, let's get to number 7. This one is 4 plus 4 minus 4 divided with 4. 4 plus 4 is 8, and 4 divided by 4 is 1, so 8 minus 1 is 7. Next, let's get to the number 8. This one is pretty simple. It's 4 plus 4 plus 4 minus 4. 4 plus 4 is 8. 4 minus 4 cancel each other, and that is, of course, equal to 8. And the last one in this bunch is number 9. So that is 4 plus 4 plus 4 divided with 4. That is, of course, 8 plus 1, which is equal to 9. And as you can see, those are our first 10 digits. Alright, so now we will do all two-digit numbers from 10 to 19. And of course, we're going to start with number 10. I got number 10 as a combination of 4 plus square root of 4 plus square root of 4 plus square root of 4. This is 4 plus 2 plus 2 plus 2, which is, of course, equal to 10. Next one is number 11, and this one is pretty interesting one, because here I used double factorial for the first time. So my take on this is 4 double factorial plus 4 minus 4 divided with 4. In this case, that is 4 times 2 plus 4 minus 1, which is equal to 8 plus 3, and that is, of course, equal to 11. Next is number 12. For this one, I used combination of 4 factorial minus 4 minus 4 minus 4. So this would be equal to 24 minus 12, which is equal to 12. And there we have our number 12. Next one is 13. And this is also a pretty interesting one. And I used double factorial as well. It is pretty similar to number 11. So it's double factorial of 4 plus 4 plus 4 divided with 4. That is 4 times 2 plus 4 plus 1, which is 8 plus 5. And that is, of course, equal to 13. Next, let's do the number 14. For this, I used square root again. So square root of 4 plus 4 plus 4 plus 4. That is 2 plus 12. And that is equal to 14. Now, let's go to the right side. Let's do the number 15 first. For this one, it's 4 times 4 minus 4 divided with 4. That is, of course, 16 minus 1, which is equal to 15. Next, let's do number 16. This is by far the easiest number, because all that you need to do is to add all 4s together, and there you go, you have number 16. 17. It's also pretty straightforward. It's 4 times 4 plus 4 divided with 4. That is 16 plus 1, and that is equal to 17. Let's get to the number 18 next. For this one, I use the combination of 4 factorial minus square root of 4 minus square root of 4 minus square root of 4. This is overall 24 minus 6, which is equal to 18. And there we have our solution. And the last, but not the least, number 19, which I got by using 4 factorial minus 4 minus 4 divided with 4. When you calculate this, you will get 24 minus 5, which is equal to 19. And there you have it. We have all numbers from 10 to 19. Well, so far, so good. And lastly, let's go to the two-digit numbers from 20 to 30. Let's start with the number 20 first. For this one, I use the combination of 4 factorial minus 4 plus 4 minus 4. Plus 4 and minus 4 will cancel each other out, and you will get 24 minus 4, which is equal to 20. Next, let's do number 21. For this one, I again used 4 factorial, but this time in combination with minus 4, plus 4 divided with 4. That is, of course, 24 minus 3, which is equal to 21. Next, let's do number 22. For this one, Again 4 factorial, but this time minus square root of 4 plus 4 minus 4. Plus and minus 4 will cancel each other out, and we're left with 24 minus 2, which is equal to 22. Next, number 23. For this one, it's 4 factorial again, but this time minus square root of 4 plus 4 divided with 4. This will be equal to 24 minus 1, and in total, that is equal to 23. Next, it's number 24. For this one, it's 4 times 4 plus 4 plus 4. I think this is the easiest combination, so that is 16 plus 8, which equals to 24. Let's get to the right side now, and let's start with number 25. For this one, it's 4 factorial plus square root of 4 minus 4 divided with 4. That is, of course, equal to 24 plus 1, which equals to 25. Let's do number 26. For this one, I again used 4 factorial, but this time I used plus square root of 4 plus 4 minus 4. Of course, plus 4 and minus 4 cancel each other out, and we are left with 24 plus 2, which equals to 26. Next, it's number 27. For this, we will start, well, you guessed it, with 4 factorial again, then plus 4 minus 4 divided with 4. This time, after solving, we are left with 24 plus 3, which equals to 27. 28, we're going to start with 4 factorial again, but this time we're going to use plus 4 plus 4 minus 4, which, of course, when we calculate, is equal to 24 plus 4, which equals to 28. Now we are getting close to the final number. Next one is 29. For this, it's 4 factorial plus 4 plus 4 divided with 4. And of course, when you calculate this, it's 24 plus 5, which equals to 29. And finally, the last but not the least, the number 30. This one I got as 4 factorial plus square root of 4 plus square root of 4 plus square root of 4. And after working through this, you will get that that is 24 plus 6, and that is equal to 30. And there you have it. We have all numbers from 0 to 30 only by using 4 fours in line, and we haven't used the brackets in any of those cases. Well, I hope you enjoyed this video, and I hope you managed to solve this problem for yourself. If you found any other combinations, and trust me, there are tons of combinations for doing this, please write it down in the comment section as you always do. Of course, if you enjoyed this video, consider leaving a like and subscribing to the channel. And as always, until next time, see you all and take care.